Gender is very much related to sex, and many people are confused about the distinction between the sex and gender. So when we say sex, it is a natural distinguishable variable. It is concerned with differentiating the people based on biological attributes. So when we say gender, it is concerned with differentiating people based on the social expectations, perceptions, and rules. So because of this, women and men are boxed in the situations which constrain their capacity to do and to be. That's why we have a GAD, or a gender and development.
When everyone believes ya, what's that like? Gender socialization. I grew up learning from my parents that there are certain activities or toys that corresponds with my gender. My family really used to give me dolls and other girl stuffs. I am also being practiced to do the household chores such as cleaning, laundry, and washing the dishes. I dress accordingly to my gender, I act accordingly to my gender, and I behave according to my gender.
This is Kate Louise D. Lopez. I am assigned and doing or performing the side of gender stereotype. Gender roles are culturally influenced stereotypes which create expectations for appropriate behavior for males and females. An understanding of this is evident in school. First scenario, girls are naturally quieter than boys. Second scenario, boys are naturally talkative than girls.
Yo, Brad! Kitang kita ko yun. Di ba naglaro kayo ni Michael? Naglaro din kami. Panalo, panalo! Panalo, Brad! Di ba, panalo, galing namin, no? Wala, wala, wala kayo sa amin, eh. Wala. Ganun, basak kami talaga ni Michael magkasama. Wala, panalo. Panalo talaga, Brad, panalo. Oh, kita mo yun, kita mo yun? Iba talaga yung move, basak kami magkasama sa Dota, eh. Ganun, ganun na ganun talaga. Basta dapat parehas eh. Parehas legendary. Parehas legendary. Epic na, epic eh. Wala, wala, wala. Oh, ganun talaga eh. Wala. Nanalo kami, nanalo talaga kami. Oh, ganun talaga. Oh, galing namin. Pinagsama, pinagsama, pinagsama. Oh, wala, wala, wala. Ganun talaga yun. Pre, yung laro din nila. Ang walang-wala din sila, pre! Ganun talaga, basta malalakas eh. Dali na, pre! Wala na klase, dali na. Dota, diba? Dota. Sabi niya eh.
Gender and development is a great topic to have knowledge on each one's right, it may be men or women. It is a way of looking at how social norms and power structures impact on the lives and opportunities available to different groups of men or women. I learned that whatever gender that person may have, he or she has the right of all things, no superior. Through this topic, it helps us to understand and develop our recognition of the status and situation of the people in our society.
Gender and development, it's enabled us to examine the challenge of the social norms, what it means to be a man and a woman in society, and to pursue justice and equality for all.
Gender stereotyping refers to the practice of ascribing to an individual, woman or man, specific attributes, characteristics, roles by reason only for her or his membership in the social group of women and men.
I have learned that gender and development refers to the development perspective and process that is participatory and empowering, equitable, sustainable, free from violence, respectful of human rights, supportive of self-determination, and actualization of human potentials. Equality between men and women exists when both sexes are able to share equally in the distribution of power and influence. Gender is an important consideration in development. It is a way of looking at how social norms and power structures impact on the lives and opportunities available to different groups of men and women.
Gender rule can be affected by religion and sexuality. Most religions order place a strong emphasis on gender religion, in turn have a big influence on gender relations. Gender and religion research derive from a broader interest in feminist anthropology, and various approaches to gender and religion research have been created. Early research looks on how religious activity affects male and female behavior. Studies in this vein look at how religion practice constrains and shape women's and men's rule, or how gender norms change when people convert to different religions. Research has looked into how gender shape religious and spiritual ethics and practice. While patriarchal relationships are important in many world religions, they are not universal. Some religious groups place a premium on cooperation and teamwork over hierarchy. Others may place a premium on male leadership, but inadvertently equip women with ethical identities and spiritual position that allows them to exercise their own agency and authority. For me, gender rules cannot be affected by religion and sexuality. It really depends on the particular person and how to handle and respect everyone's decision and how they want to be as an individual. Respecting a person's perspective will not affect religion and their sexuality. Your role and sexuality will not define the things on how or what you are capable of. Let's just put you in a situation where you are a gay person. Your role as an individual will not affect your sexuality or religion. Your role as a person and what you are capable of do not stop in there as long as you give respect to others.
Bloopers.
Ikaw kaya ang ganyan. Pre, alam mo ba, pre? Alam mo ba, crush ko yung babae doon, pre? Oh, ganda yan, pre. Ganun talaga ba? So, magaganda eh. Liligawan ko yung mamaya, pre.
Wow.
Liligawan ko yun. Ano sabi mo? Ha? Hindi maganda? Pangit? Hindi na lang. Huwag na lang, pre. Tayo na.